We're going to need darkness for our next adventure, so late in the afternoon we leave town and head south again on Highway 50, past the Cave Lake area and the junction of Highway 93. We don't want to give too many specifics here because we want the location we're visiting to be as protected as possible, but we can say that somewhere on this stretch we leave the highway and meet Jason Williams, a bat researcher with the Nevada Department of Wildlife. He's been studying bats out here for years.
Jason, thanks for meeting us.
Absolutely.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Welcome to Eastern Nevada.
Beautiful out here. So where's the cave from here?
It's right up here, underneath that arch.
So we got a little hike ahead of us.
Yep.
All right.
Let's go.
So how many times have you had people make some variety of joke about you being the Batman?
Way too many. So here's where it gets a little more vertical. There's a hand line up here if you need it.
I think I'm definitely going to use the hand line.
And we'll just go up one at a time.
Okay. So Jason, I take it this is where the real research happens.
Yep. We use this site to study bats. This is a migration stopover for Mexican free-tailed bats.
Jason's research team is made up of a combination of students and some volunteers. If you think you'd like to stay up all night and tag bats, you could volunteer too. You can find out how at endow.org.
So this is a harp trap, and it's named after, you know, a musical harp. So those are monofilament lines, basically fishing line, that are about an inch apart. And there's two strands of them. So the bats will turn and fly right through one strand, but they'll get caught on the second strand. We can look at ingress, animals flying in, and egress, animals flying out. We use a beam break system. Like when you walk into a convenience store, a 7-Eleven or something, you break that,
right,
that IR beam.
Bing bong.
A computer records all of these beam breaks, so we know when the bats are showing up in the early summer, we know when they're leaving in the fall, and we know nightly activity by the hour and what's going on every night.
So depending on which beam they break first, you know if they're coming back in or if they're going out.
Yep.
So how many bats visit this cave in a year?
We estimate 1 to 2 million per year.
That's quite an impressive number. Why do they like this place so much?
So this particular species, Tenarda brasiliensis, the Mexican free-tailed bats, they like to roost in big open caves, and they will create their own environment. So they need a big room. They'll get so many individuals together that they can create their own climate.
And I guess if they're that many together, it's hot is what they like.
They like it really hot and really humid.
Do they more or less come out around the same time period?
Usually it's about 15 minutes after local sunset is when it happens.
Just climbing up to the cave has provided some reward for us. A sublime view of Spring Valley, which only becomes better as we watch the sun drop.
It already feels like a privilege just to be here. As the darkness comes, the team gets ready to go to work. And soon...
So tonight, we're in our third year of a banding project. We have these little aluminum bands with individual serial numbers on them, and we place them on the right forearm. And then these animals, you know, a portion of them will be recaptured elsewhere in the country throughout their lives. And researchers will, if they see those bands, they're going to know that it needs to be returned to somebody. And the bat world's kind of small, so it's easy to figure out who those are.
Animal lovers have no fear. The researchers use tools that wrap the band around the wing without doing any damage to the bats. It allows them to move like they would normally.
We've enjoyed an experience unlike anything we've ever seen during this series. We got to meet a real, I'm going to say it, Batman, and learn a lot more about the natural world around Ely.
And we combined that with the beauty of Cave Lake State Park and got to go on a journey into Ely's railroad history.
made for a great trip.
Sure did. I hope you've enjoyed watching it as much as we have enjoyed doing it. And until our next Wild Nevada adventure, please get out there and enjoy this beautiful state for yourself.
We're going to take wing now.